Hello, friend. I like this game. Toree! 3D. This was a game I picked probably a couple years ago now because I remember someone mentioning it in one of my Game of the Year videos. They said it was one of the better games they played that year, and I was kind of interested. That, and the developer seems to have a penchant for making retro-style platformers like that of the Sega Saturn and N64, which immediately drew my attention to them. I then immediately snapped up every game they made in their back catalog, although since then I think they've made two more I should probably pick up at some point. But I played it for Halloween this year because, and I wasn't really expecting this to be the case, this had horror in its tags. And I didn't see anything particularly horrific about the game. I mean, it just looked like a cute little platformer where you play a bird. The titular Toree, of course, is Japanese for bird, but they spelled it differently, don't worry about it. And yet, it was kind of a horror experience in some ways. But at the same time, while I did enjoy this game, and I think it's a really fun game to play and would probably be a really fun speedrun game, I feel like it's really at odds with itself. The story itself stars the titular Toree. You don't really get much more than that. He's a little bird thing with little sunglasses, and he's super adorbs. Now, from what I can tell, it seems like his ice cream was stolen by some grim reaper made out of broken code, and he's kind of messing up the world, so Toree needs to be the absolute hero that he is destined to be and go get his ice cream back, because who cares about the fate of the world or this grim reaper thing, right? The thing about this game that really bugs me is that it feels tonally inconsistent with what it's trying to be. On one hand, you have Toree, this cute little bird platformer collecting stars, trying to get to the finish so that he can get his ice cream back. On the other hand, though, you have this evil glitch reaper thing destroying the world and creating all sorts of havoc for Toree, and really is the source of all the horror in this game. There are moments where the game goes really dark, or at least tries to be, but at the same time, it feels like it kinda just doesn't understand what its tone is gonna be. Like, it's trying to be a cute platformer, but then you suddenly run into these enemies with, like, big spiky teeth that are probably supposed to be scary, but they just kind of come off as, like, goofy and out of place more than anything. This honestly feels like it's trying to be one of those games from those, like, really crappy creepypastas from 10 years ago where it's, oh, it's a super cute game, but it's cursed, so if you play it, the bird will jump out of the TV and it'll be like hyper realistic and it'll bite your face off because they'll think it's ice cream or something. But it never really follows through with that sort of promise of full-blown horror. It's just, here's a couple creepy moments in an actually otherwise happy little platformer. And it just comes across as tonally weird because of it. There's a couple moments where monsters will chase you, and there's a bit of a loud noise, and as someone with audio sensitivity, that's a little annoying. But aside from, like, one specific moment, there's nothing about this game that ever feels really scary or like it's trying to be horror. It just feels more like it doesn't know what tone it wants to take with this game. And because of that inconsistency, it's a little hard to take seriously when it is trying to be scary. Like I said, there's spooky enemies that really just made me laugh more than anything. The gameplay to Toree 3D is pretty simple. You can run, you can jump, you can double jump, and your goal is to get to the end. Along the way, you can collect various little tiny stars that, if you do so, you can unlock a special character that has different abilities, and you are graded on your performance and speed by the end. If you get the highest score, you unlock a different character with presumably different abilities. I didn't get that character though. If you manage to beat every single level, you'll unlock the final level where you confront the Reaper. Sorta. He's really more just sort of chilling as you wander by, but yeah, that's a confrontation, I guess, sorta. Even though there's better confrontation sort of earlier. But between then and now, it's really just platform to the end and don't die or get eaten by monsters that will definitely eat you. The gameplay itself is pretty simple, and aside from a couple of moments where the game's tone decides to shift a little bit, it's just a bright, cheery, nice, comfy platformer. I actually really like this game, and you know, the platforming works really, really well. A few of the levels try and change up the mechanics slightly. With the exception of the final unlockable level, each level has two variations of it across the board. You start off on a rooftop level, which has cranes you have to ride automatically to get to the end, whereas the next level is set in the ocean where you don't want to fall in, and it's definitely not Metal Harbor from Sonic Adventure 2, But I love that game, so it's a great callback. You have a snow level, which utilizes ice physics, and I gotta say, the ice physics in this game are completely borked. If you try jumping on ice, the momentum just kind of goes crazy, and it's really hard to control. It's not a fun mechanic at all, but those levels aren't that bad. And finally, you have a level that seems to be based in some sort of Japanese highway, where you're jumping from truck to truck to truck. It's pretty exciting and neat. Also, there's some wicked traffic accidents in there. But as the levels go on, it feels like the Glitch Reaper's influence is affecting the game more and more, so there is more darker elements coming out. But at the same time, it still, like I said, doesn't feel like it's trying to be a horror game. It doesn't really know what it's trying to be. It just kind of comes across as weird. But I do appreciate that it is a more gradual thing than just in your face at the front. It does sort of ease you into the quote-unquote horror bits, and it does make it feel a lot more natural and a lot more of a attempt at a serious scare, because you're more settled into a cute platformer, but the scare doesn't really feel all that effective so much as just creates a bit of a tonal dissonance. The gameplay itself, however, as a platformer is stellar, and it's a lot of fun. When you unlock new characters, they have different abilities, and it's really quite enjoyable. Overall, gameplay-wise, there's not really much to talk about. I've kind of said everything already, but it was a fun game. It was not a super long game. I completed my entire playthrough in probably about 40 minutes or so. I beat this back-to-back with Gorf the Ghost in under an hour, and that's actually why I'm talking about this now. I have all this footage, I might as well use it. And I gotta say, well, it's not a super long game, and I think it's tonally a bit uncertain about what it's trying to do. As a game and as a platformer, it's really a lot of fun, and it does encourage speedrunning and, you know, execution. And I think it's quite fun. The overall presentation to Toree 3D is excellent. Visually, it does everything it needs to do to work perfectly fine. I think the levels look great, and the individual elements of every stage are fantastic. When it tries to execute its horror bits, like I said, some of it's kind of goofy. There is one thing that was a little bit actually unsettling. Overall, it visually works quite well, and the audio, let me tell you, is way better than it has any right to be. The two tracks for Not Quite Metal Harbor absolutely slap, and those two tracks alone, I might have to track down the soundtrack to this just for that, because those were really unbelievably good. Overall, the presentation at Toree 3D is not only fitting, but really well executed, and I enjoyed it quite a lot. Now, if you want a copy of Toree 3D on the PC, you can get it right now for $1.20, and for that price, it is absolutely worth it. Like I said, the tone is a little bit wonky, but the game as a game is fantastic, and honestly, for a buck, totally worth it. There's also a sequel, which I have not touched, but maybe next Halloween, or, you know, there's a little bit of time left, maybe this one, we'll see. And apparently there's a Toree Saturn coming out to make it a proper trilogy, and I mean, like I said, I bought pretty much the entire back catalog of this developer, aside from their sort of almost Donkey Kong Country-esque looking platformer. I'm gonna have to grab that next time I'm on Steam. But Toree Saturn is looking good. I'm looking at the trailer right now, and it is looking like Toree, but faster and better in every way. Basically, this is a really fun, well-executed game that is dirt cheap, and you should play it because it's good. I think it was also available on one of those haunted PS1 game compilations from Itch. I swear I've seen it on one of those, but I couldn't tell you which one offhand. But for a dollar, Toree 3D is a lot of fun. It's a little tonally weird, and I'm not sure it accomplishes what it necessarily sets out to do with its tonal choices, but as a platformer and as a game, for a dollar, it is fantastic. Especially if you are a fan of retro-style platformers or just well-executed platformers. Grab this one if you can. It's good. Whoa. Okay. Are you evil? Yup.